Hi, Alexey Gusenov here. Building a good audio speaker is an intricate craft. But if we don't aim for sound quality, things get way easier. Take a sheet of paper, slap on top some wire with a sellotape, connect it to an amplifier, and add a magnet. By lifting the paper, I can let it move freely and work better. This actually will work with stiffer wire and even with rather small magnets like this tiny bit. Though be warned that this coil has way lower resistance than a normal speaker, so don't do this with an amplifier you can't afford to burn.
Actually, with powerful enough amplifier, lots of things will start emitting sound.
So that's why I got this thing which can deliver several hundred watts of power. I'm not the first person to connect light bulb to an amplifier, however, I did do a couple of things differently. Most importantly, I've added a magnet. Oscillating current in light bulb's filament creates an electric field, but for it to become a motion, we need a magnetic field from which it can push or pull. Using small halogen bulbs allowed to place magnet close to the filament. This horn helps to transfer vibrations from bulbs to the air, making the speaker a little bit louder. Resistor here matches the resistance of the overall setup to what a regular speaker would have. Without it, this amplifier would just burn. And the final touch is a special preheat tone.
While the filament is cold, the sound has a distinct metallic tone. However, when it heats up, the sound quality significantly improves. By complementing silent periods with inaudible 10 Hz tone, I keep the spiral hot and reduce distortion.
Without further ado, I introduce you a not so loud but still pretty audible, extremely power-hungry lo-fi disco light speaker.